My name is Abdullah the Butcher.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Iyad, aka the Beast from the Middle East. And before I start talking about Abdullah the Butcher, let me tell you a quick story. One night in 2007, I was channel surfing and happened to stumble upon WWE's Legends of Wrestling. And I loved that show because I got to learn about a lot of legendary wrestlers that were from before my time. And that specific episode that I happened to stumble upon was titled Bad Asses. And that was when I heard this name for the first time. Abdullah the Butcher, the madman from Sudan.
Abdullah the Butcher was an individual.
And he instantly grabbed my attention. I wanted to know everything about Abdullah the Butcher. Who is he? How come I never heard of him before? And obviously one of the main reasons that I was intrigued at that moment, being from Bahrain, from the Middle East, as a kid watching wrestling, I always wanted to see a wrestler that represented me and my part of the world. Especially if you were watching WWE in the 90s, which is basically all we got over here. All we had was WWE. And in the 90s, they seemed to have wrestlers and gimmicks from all around the world. I mean, you had Canadian Mounties, British Bulldogs, and even a Portuguese Man of War. Whatever that means. I still think they should have gone with the Jerry Seinfeld gimmick for just incredible. I can totally see him pull that gimmick off and coming out to the ring with comedy material like, "What's the deal with these referees? They always seem to be distracted at the worst time during a match." But I digress. So that was kind of what the wrestling fans would talk about in the schoolyard. What if there was an Arabian wrestler in WWE? What would he look like? And what would his moves be? No, Muhammad Hassan, no, you're Italian, not Arab.
The wild man from the Sudan, Abdullah the Butcher.
And I know that there were a few wrestlers in the past that had the Arabian Sheik gimmick, like the Great Mephisto, Skander Akbar, the original Sheik, and apparently even Kenny Omega's uncle, the Golden Sheik, who I'm really interested to learn more about, perhaps another time. But like Abdullah, all these wrestlers were also before my time. As a matter of fact, Abdullah debuted in 1958 and wrestled through the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and 2000s. So he was still active when I started watching wrestling in the 90s. And throughout his career, wrestled a who's who's list of legends and Hall of Famers all around the world. And perhaps the reason to his longevity in wrestling was that he never stayed in the same territory in North America for too long. Yet he was popular in every territory he walked into.
But Abby comes through like once a year and holy cow, and he was amazing and great.
But his popularity in North America pales in comparison to his gigantic popularity in Japan. To say that Abdullah the Butcher was big in Japan is a huge understatement. He was a legend, an icon, and a household name in Japan, and not just with wrestling fans. And although I only heard about him for the first time in 2007, I instantly felt like he looked kind of familiar to me. As unique as Abdullah the Butcher looks, I felt like I've seen him somewhere before. Then I realized I've seen him in many places before, in a lot of video games that I used to play as a kid. And I'm not just talking about wrestling video games. If you used to play a lot of beat-em-up games like I used to do back in the arcades, you've probably seen Abby in one form or another. Don't tell him I called him Abby, only his friends get to call him Abby. It's kinda like how a lot of fighting games would have a character that is based or inspired by Bruce Lee. It appears that Abdullah the Butcher has inspired a lot of people who went on to create a lot of video games, mangas, and animes in Japan. So I went back and revisited a lot of games to try and find all the characters that were inspired by Abdullah the Butcher. And of course, during the process, I fell down the Abdullah the Butcher in Japan rabbit hole and found way more than I bargained for. So I'm going to show you all the inspirations and references of Abdullah the Butcher in Japanese pop culture. And a few notes before we get started, where I couldn't find definitive confirmation from the creators that indeed this character was based on Abdullah the Butcher, I have developed my own criteria of characteristics and motifs of Abdullah the Butcher that I'll be judging if these characters are indeed based and inspired by him. These include the general look of Abdullah, which is fairly unique, the scars on his head, the curled up boots, and no, I've never worn one of these, no one does. Karate skills and moves, the fireball, and finally, his famous fork.
Butcher's eating you now.
And to be honest, I only had to use this checklist with a few of the characters I'll be mentioning, because most of the characters I'll be mentioning, the creators of these characters have already confirmed that yes, the inspiration for these characters was Abdullah the Butcher. And in some of them, it's pretty obvious he was.
Cause there's only one, Abdullah the Butcher.
Nobody, and I say this all the time, and you'll get it, nobody looks like Abdullah the Butcher anymore. Mm-hmm.
So let's get started and take a look at the influence of Abdullah the Butcher on Japanese pop culture. And we'll be taking a look at his appearances and references of him in different medias.
This is Butcher Mania, and Abdullah the Butcher is the baddest.
The almighty Abdullah the Butcher!
First, let's start with a list of anime. The earliest anime I could find that had a character that was inspired by Abdullah the Butcher was Mazinger from 1972. The giant evil robot in the 8th episode was called Mechanical Beast Abdullah U6. And look at him, he's even doing a karate pose. And Abdullah U6 appears in other subsequent shows from the Mazinger series. Next, we have another giant robot anime, Zombot 3 from 1977, and the main villain in this series is called Killer Zabucha. Third, we have Mr. Hart from the popular anime series Fist of the North Star from 1984. In the Pokemon series, the design of Machope, Machoke, and Machamp drew inspiration from Abdullah the Butcher, specifically with the ridges on their heads, which were inspired by the scars on Abdullah's forehead, and the red stripes on Machoke's body, which are supposed to be his muscles, are also inspired by the scars on Abdullah's forehead. Pokemon. In the final episode of The Great Dangoyo from 2001, the heroes face off against three alien robots, and one of them is called Butcheru, and not just that, his foot is curled, just like Abdullah's curled boots. And he's also showing some mad karate skills. In Air Gear from 2006, we have one of the main characters, Isa Mihotoke, who is also nicknamed Butcha. And basically, this guy is a teenage Abdullah the Butcher on rollerblades. And this anime kind of looks cool. I don't know how I haven't heard of it before. Has a nice vibe, rollerblades, and some funky beats. Who was composing for this show? Hideki Naganuma has two songs in this show. Of course he does. The famous composer from Jet Set Radio. I should have guessed. The show has rollerblades and funky beats. Hideki Naganuma was bound to have some of his songs in this anime. In the popular anime series One Piece, there are tons of character designs that were inspired by professional wrestlers, and perhaps that's a topic for another video. In episode 633, we see the first appearance of this guy, Abdullah the Criminal, with scars on his forehead and two big forks in his hands, just to let you know for sure that he was inspired by Abdullah the Butcher. And we also have his partner in crime, Jetto, who was modeled after Tiger Jeet Singh. 元賞金稼ぎ、政府機関爆破事件のアブドーランド・ジェット。 Of course, we can't talk about wrestling and anime without talking about Tiger Mask, specifically Tiger Mask 2 from 1981. Abdullah the Butcher appears in multiple episodes in Tiger Mask 2, and he faced the protagonist of the show Tiger Mask in the ring, and in the show they gave him the saddest backstory ever. You couldn't turn someone babyface quicker. And finally, in episode 125 from the anime Kaibutsu-kun, the main characters go and watch a wrestling show. And what a wrestling show it was! It had a battle royal filled with legends and Hall of Famers like Inoki, Giant Baba, Hulk Hogan, Stan Hansen, and Abdullah the Butcher. And we also get to see Ric Flair, Mil Máscaras, and Andre the Giant in the backstage area. And of course, Abdullah and Tiger Jeet Singh illuminate themselves and start fighting in the crowd. It's great to see that even anime creators in the 80s were protecting Abby in a battle royale, and making sure he looks strong even if he doesn't win that battle royale. Before we move on to video games, if there are any other anime characters that were inspired by Abdullah the Butcher that you know of, please mention them in the comments.
The wild man from the Sudan, remember the name, Abdullah the Butcher. The Butcher, the Butcher.
And now let's get to my favorite part, video games, and let's start with my favorite type of games, arcade games. The earliest game that I can find a character in it that was inspired by Abdullah the Butcher was Apu from 1984, a wrestling game developed by Sega, and the character was called A Bucci. Next we have Buchu from the arcade game ER Kung Fu from 1985. Bruno from the Double Dragon series. Earlier designs to the character may not resemble Abdullah the Butcher, but later redesigns of the character make it more obvious that the character design was indeed inspired by Abdullah the Butcher. He's got the size, the curled boots, and spits fire.
It's a joke, isn't it?
Mono, win!
Next, we have Karnov from the Karnov series from Data East. While the original design of Karnov is said to be based on another pro wrestler, Ox Baker, the later redesign to the character saw him look more like Abdullah the Butcher. And Karnov is a very interesting character in the world of video games because not only does he appear in his own games and spin-off games and other games from Data East, but he also cameos in other games from different companies. So let me take a minute to list some of the games that Karnov appears in. We have the original game Karnov, and then Karnov's Revenge, Fighter's History, and then he appears as an enemy in these games, Garyo Retsuden, Tumble Pop, Trio the Punch, and in Trio the Punch, he's everywhere. In Bad Dudes vs. Dragon Ninja, he's the first level boss. In Joe and Mac Return, he's in the special stage. And in Street Slam, he's in the background of one of the levels. And these are all games developed by Data East that Karnov appears in. But Karnov's most interesting cameo or appearance happens in Shantae and the Pirate's Curse, developed by Way Forward. In the game, Shantae encounters a shadowy figure, and it is implied that he is Karnov, plus he's Shantae's father. So technically, could we say that Shantae is the daughter of Abdullah the Butcher?
Shantae!
Boris the Skinhead is the first level boss from the 1990 arcade game AB Cop. Violent Storm from 1993, developed by Konami, had this character, Lollipop. And although I couldn't find any confirmation that this character was based on Abdullah the Butcher, I didn't need to go through my checklist to confirm that because these two guys are based on the Road Warriors and this guy is based on Bruiser Brody. So I think it's safe to assume that Lollipop is based on Abdullah the Butcher. But he does spit fire and wears curled up shoes. Three Count Bout from 1993, developed by SNK, also known as Fire Suplex in Japan, didn't only have one character based on Abdullah the Butcher, but it had two. Well, actually, it's the same guy, he just wears a mask when he's pretending to be a babyface, but you do get two playable characters. The masked babyface is Blues Heblum, and the heel is Blubber Man. Such a heel name. Wait, why is the babyface using a knife? Muscle Bomber, or as it's known around the world, Saturday Night Slam Masters, from 1993. This is the third game from that year that featured Abdullah. Why was he on the minds of game developers from 1993? I wonder what he was doing back then. Let me check. In 1993, Abdullah arrived in ECW. Okay, that explains everything. In Saturday Night Slam Masters, the character Jumbo Flapjack, whose name in the Japanese version is Kimala the Bouncer, the design of this character is not only inspired by Abdullah the Butcher, but it's also inspired by John Tenta and Kamala. And the character designer in this game is actually the creator of Fist of the North Star, Tatsuyu Hara. And it's nice to see that he uses Abdullah as an inspiration for characters he creates for different works. I guess he must have been a fan. There is another wink and nod at Abdullah in the game, specifically in the English version. The profile of the character Alexander the Greater, who is obviously based off of Vader, states that he's a butcher by day and a greater by night. Which I think is an obvious reference and nod to Abdullah the Butcher, because there's only one butcher in wrestling. Sorry, the butcher from AEW, there's only one butcher in wrestling.
Just try to make nice.
He's a butcher, by the way. You get it?
Yeah, I get it. He had a cleaver in his hand.
Best Bout Boxing from 1994 had Australian boxer named Biff Fulge, which sounds like Beef Burger. And oh my god, he's bleeding in the character select screen. He's already bleeding. Osman from 1996 was a game developed by the same developer as the hit arcade game Strider and is considered by many as the spiritual successor and unofficial sequel to Strider. And the main villain and final boss of this game is called Abdullah the Slaver. Arabian Magic from 1992, developed by Taito. In one of the boss fights in the game, you'll face not one but two Abdullah the Butchers. Wrestle War, that was developed by Sega and released in the arcades in 1989 and later released on the Sega Mega Drive in 1991. All the characters in the game seem to be inspired by real-life wrestlers, and one of them was even based on Jason Voorhees. And the final boss in the game, Grand Kong, was based on Abdullah the Butcher. Speaking of the Sega Mega Drive, let's move on to the home console games that had Abby in them or a character inspired by Abby. But first, let me mention my favorite game from all the games I'm mentioning in this video. Hanataka Daka on the PC Engine, which is also known as the TurboGrafx-16 outside of Japan. The game was released in 1991 and the first level boss is Abdullah the Butcher in potato form. And he spits blood at you. How apropos. And there's a ring in the background while you're fighting him. And I'll be honest, I kind of like this cute 'em up chibi kawaii version of Abby. Now let's take a look at some home console games that either had Abdullah in them as himself or characters inspired by him. And they are all wrestling games and in no particular order.
Superstar Pro Wrestling!
Abdullah is also a playable character in the Legends of Wrestling series. And King of the Colosseum.
Abdullah!
and Wrestle Kingdom 2 on the PS2, which Abdullah and the Destroyer took part in promoting the game in Japan, and obviously Abby promoted the game in his unique way, and to be honest, if I saw this back in the day, I would have bought 10 copies of the game. Let me know in the comments if there are any other games that have a character that's inspired or you think is inspired by Abdullah the Butcher. I would like to check them out because I'm sure I missed a few games here and there. If you are still like me and still hadn't had enough of Abdullah the Butcher yet and want to see more, don't worry, we're going deeper into the rabbit hole.
Most noble man in this world, strongest man, you gone nuts, you are crazy, you cannot touch my Abdullah the Butcher, he is the strongest man.
And now let's take a look at Abdullah the Butcher in Japanese cinema and movies. In the 1981 kung fu movie Roaring Fire, Abdullah the Butcher plays the role of Spartacus. Oh my god, this is hilarious. This is epic. Rewind. Hayokite Spartacusu. And hold on a second, was he just underwater waiting for them to call him? Or summon him because, you know, he's the black magician? No, wait, I figured it out. Ladies and gentlemen, apparently Abdullah the Butcher could breathe underwater through his scars on his head. The 2007 movie Adrift in Tokyo. No, not Tokyo Drift. I know. I thought the same thing too. Not Tokyo Drift, Adrift in Tokyo. Nonetheless, there was a really, really nice reference to Abdullah in this movie because there was a butcher shop in this movie that was appropriately named Abdullah the Butcher.
I don't care!
And after I couldn't find any more references to Abdullah in Japanese movies, I decided to head west to Hollywood to see if there are any Western movies that have references to Abdullah in them. But I found a surprise up north with the Canadian movie Caged Men from 1971, which predates Roaring Fire by 10 years, so that makes it the first movie that Abdullah ever appeared and acted in, and he played the role of Abdullah. I found the trailer of this movie on YouTube, but I can't seem to find Abdullah in it. Let me see if I can find any reviews of this movie. I'm kinda interested. Okay, so no review on Rotten Tomato, but why is it called Caged Men Plus One Woman? I'm going to get you, Elliot Boy. It is the same movie. I can see Abdullah on the poster here. And the movie's name on the poster is Caged Men, I'm Gonna Get You, Elliot Boy. And on the top it says Maria's B-Movie Mayhem? Okay, there's something about this movie. I don't know what it is that's drawing me to it. It's like the less info I can find about this movie, the more I'm drawn to it. Let me go check IMDb and see if I can find anything. Okay, Caged Men, 1971. I'm Going to Get You, Elliot Boy, original title, crime drama, 2nd of June. Wait, this movie was released on my birthday? Of course it was. That explains everything. Okay, let's just read this description. Elliot is a loser who robbed a bank and landed in jail after being set up by his girlfriend. Elliot is considered fresh meat and encounters inmates trying to make him their own at every turn. Man, I need to learn more about this movie. Here we go, user reviews. Fans of really obscure, so bad it's good stuff might enjoy this What Were They Thinking affair. Shot in Canada in 1971. A very stupid young man attempts to rob a bank to impress a very trashy girlfriend. Hey, these people smoke a lot of pot. You know what? I'm just gonna watch the movie. And on my birthday too, which coincidentally happens to be the movie's 50 year anniversary. That's something to look forward to. Wait a minute, hold on. Quentin Tarantino showed this movie in Tarantino Fest 2006? Okay, I got to watch this movie. And in the 2006 movie ATL, Abdullah and his world-famous House of Ribs and Chinese Food were mentioned. And these are all the movies that Abdullah was in and referenced in. And to be honest, we need more Abdullah the Butcher references in movies and references to his restaurant as well.
Man, you
ain't never had no real barbecue to at JJ's Rib Shack. Man, I don't even know how you living.
I don't know how you living because you ain't had nothing to you at Abdul's Rib Shack. I know he's a pro wrestler and everything, but obviously you can make some sauce.
In Atlanta!
But now let's head back to Japan and look at the things they play before the movies in the cinema or during your favorite TV show or YouTube video. And let's look at commercials that had Abdullah the Butcher in them. If you thought Hulk Hogan's Japanese commercials were weird, well, you haven't seen a thing until you've seen Abdullah the Butcher in a commercial. What have they done to you, Abby? Abby appeared in multiple commercials in Japan for different products that include Suntory lemon drink, Denon cassette tapes, and Daikin air conditioners. Tell me you wouldn't buy this air conditioner if you saw this commercial back in the day. Abdullah the Butcher is featured in almost every wrestling manga you can find out there, and obviously he's in the mangas of all the animes that we mentioned earlier, but he was also the star of his own comedy manga series titled Itoshi no Butcha, which translates to My Beloved Butcher, and had 8 books in the series. There's something about Chibi and Kawaii Abdullah the Butcher that makes me want to see more of it.
Yeah, you people know who I am. I'm Abdullah the Butcher.
Music and wrestling go so well together. Wrestlers have been releasing albums since forever. I mean, who could forget such hits as Jerry the King's World's Greatest Wrestler?
I'm the world's greatest wrestler. I'm the best you've ever seen.
Or Michael P.S. Hayes' Bad Street USA. Or Terry Funk's mega hit, Barbra Streisand's Nose.
She had Barbra Streisand's Nose.
And Abby was not immune to this phenomenon because he had his own album titled The Butcher by The Suplex and Abdullah the Butcher that only had 2 tracks on it. First song is The Butcher. Second song is Butcher the Greatest. Okay, they kept it simple. And when you think Abdullah the Butcher plus music album, your mind would assume instantly that it would be a death metal album. But the songs in the album are actually jazzy and kind of funky, and I like them.
Go, go, butcher, hip hop butcher, come on, baby, proper one.
And the words Abdullah says in one of the songs are just crazy. Words that should never be in any song ever. But I gotta say, he made them work.
My mother and father told me, son! Get out of the ring! You're too crazy! I looked at him, I saw the lock, and I said...
How have I lived this long without jamming to this awesome, awesome, awesome song? That's it. This is my new ringtone from now on.
I'm gonna be... I'm gonna stop you in the ground! I'm gonna let the world know who the butcher is!
And Abdullah was featured on some album covers like Lemon Kiss by Apache. And Lemon Kiss was the same song used in the Suntory lemon drink commercials. And a drawing of him was the cover art for Carl Douglas's MORF single album. And the American punk rock band Anti-Scene had an album called Dear Abby that had 4 songs on it. Dear Abby, Sabu, Funk You, Cactus Jack.
Wait a second! That's Abdullah the Butcher!
Abdullah the Butcher and his world-famous House of Ribs and Chinese Food have both appeared in the music video for the song Damn by Young Bloods. And he is in full wrestling and Abby mode in this music video, and I wouldn't expect anything less from him. Yo, Abby, are you looking for any franchising opportunities outside of the US? Please call me. Now let's take a look at one last avenue of pop culture. Wrestling is a form of pop culture, right? Well, at least it is to me. And you know what they say, wrestling is a parody of itself. So let's see if there are any inspirations and references of Abdullah the Butcher in wrestling. First we have Abdullah Kobayashi, who is also known as Abdullah Jr., who was actually trained by Abdullah the Butcher and modeled his career and wrestling style after Abdullah the Butcher, and is a very popular wrestler in the Japanese deathmatch wrestling scene.
Abdullah Jr. Kobayashi.
Next, let's head to Mexico and take a look at Abdullah Tamba, who first wrestled under the name Tamba and was nicknamed El Elefante Volador, the Flying Elephant. But after he teamed up with Abdullah the Butcher in the 80s, Abdullah liked him and sent him to Puerto Rico to wrestle Carlos Colon. And when he came back, the name Abdullah Tamba was bestowed upon him. And then there was Muhammad the Butcher. And of course, this was in the UWF. Only the mind of Herb Abrams would come up with something like this.
On the Fury Hour, I'm Craig DeGeorge with Bruno Sammartino. Oh! Fire! Fire! Fire!
The Arabian Butchers. Oh my God, no, 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 no. No, Corny, no. Run in the other direction. Run in the other direction. Don't head to the ring with these guys. Owen Hart just bailed. He just left. He just went to the back. Out of all the tag teams that Jim Cornette has ever walked to the ring with, these two have to be the worst. And you can hear it so clearly, people in the crowd are shouting Abdullah the Butcher.
Good Lord Almighty. Goody.
I'm pretty sure Death Kamu, the mascot of BGW, was inspired by Abdullah the Butcher. Don't ask me how I know, it's just a feeling.
There is only one Abdullah the Butcher. He has been imitated, but nobody has ever
nobody can imitate that.
And to this day, you might hear Abby's name mentioned on commentary during matches, but let me give you my two favorites.
Oh yeah, yeah. Do the Abby.
Yeah.
Shades Abdullah.
It's tribute night.
I love it.
Taz makes the Abby sound like it's a 70s disco dance move.
Do the Abby.
And more recently on AEW Dynamite, Tony Schiavone mentioned Abdullah the Butcher at the perfect moment. So thank you, Tony.
You know, when I'm in the ring, if you came and searched me, you know what you'd find? A fork. You'd find brass knuckles.
Okay.
You'd find a pencil.
A fork.
That's right.
Abdullah the Butcher.
Absolutely.
My God.
I learned from the best, Tony.
Abdullah the Butcher proved something that's kind of counterintuitive for us wrestling fans. Because we're used to see wrestling borrow and take inspiration from pop culture, from movies, TV shows, and music. A recent example of this is WWE's Raw Underground, where they flat out ripped off my favorite movie ever, Fight Club. WWE has even took inspiration from the Jerry Springer Show. Yes, I'm looking at you, Vinnie Roo.
Bro.
But with Abdullah the Butcher, we're seeing the opposite of that. We're seeing manga and anime creators and game developers borrow and draw inspiration from wrestling, from Abdullah the Butcher specifically. And it's obvious that he left his mark on those Japanese fans who went on to create all those works that they used him as an inspiration for some of their characters. And I'm gonna say this, Abby was made for wrestling. Abby was only gonna sprout out of the crazy world of professional wrestling. Only in wrestling would someone like Abby rise to legendary status and inspire generations of creators. Can you think of any other profession in the world that would give birth to a guy like Abdullah the Butcher? And can you imagine the world without Abby?
This particular home video is entitled Butcher Mania, and it is Butcher Mania.
Thank you to everyone who reached the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave a comment. And don't forget to do the Abby the next time you bust some disco dancing moves.
Go, go, butcha, get my butcha, I'm a baby bride for one.